My name is Jan Ehrchen. I'm working at the Department of Dermatology at the University Hospital of Münster. I'm specialized in the treatment of patients with autoimmune disorders, and I want to present a case to you of a peculiar patient which we've treated in our department. The patient was a 56-year-old male who's just flown back from holiday on a Mediterranean island. And shortly after arriving in Münster, he developed a severe swelling of his right leg, redness and swelling of his right leg. Of course, venous thrombosis is the thing which you have in mind after traveling by plane, but this was ruled out when the patient presented out at our outpatient clinic. We examined the patient, and we not only focused on the most obvious sign, which was this large, swollen, wet leg of the patient, but we also inspected the whole skin of the patient. And then we found a levite, which means red, purple erythema at his scalp and his hairline. Additionally, we performed blood tests, and we found massively elevated muscle enzymes in this patient. The creatine kinase was like 1,300 units per liter. Other muscle enzymes were also elevated. We then tested for autoimmunity. We tested for antinuclear antibodies. We found antinuclear antibodies, but we did not find any specific antibody in this patient. Important thing to really make a diagnosis, a definite diagnosis in dermatology, is skin biopsy. And we found so-called interface dermatitis, which means that there's inflammation at the border of the epidermis and dermis. But we also found some inflammatory cells in the deeper layer of the dermis and also in the subcutaneous tissue, which we call panniculitis, which means inflammation of the fatty tissue, which is quite a peculiar finding. Further diagnostic workup in the patient now included imaging of the leg. We did magnetic resonance imaging, and we found inflammation of the subcutaneous tissue, and we also found edema, meaning inflammation of the muscles of the patient in his upper and his lower leg. Given the finding of the magnetic resonance imaging, we additionally performed muscle biopsy. However, we were not able to detect any specific inflammatory changes in the muscle. Nevertheless, given all the findings which we had, we were able to make the diagnosis of dermatomyositis with peculiar involvement of the fatty tissue, so dermatomyositis with panniculitis. Dermatomyositis is a rare autoimmune disease which typically involves both the skin and also the muscles of your body. The muscle signs are usually at the proximal muscles of the arms and of the legs. So some important clinical signs are that you have difficulties lifting your arms, and you can have difficulties standing up from a sitting position. Not only the muscles and the skin are involved in dermatomyositis, but internal organs like the heart or the lung can also be involved, and there is a peculiar association with malignancy, so malignancy has to be ruled out in every patient. So of course we also ruled out malignancy in our patient, and fortunately, doing an appropriate workup, we did not find any evidence of malignancy. So we have to start therapy of the patient. The initial therapy is high-dose systemic steroids. We've given the steroids for our patient intravenously. We treated him with 1,000 milligrams of prednisolone on 3 consecutive days. But even repeating this for several times over the weeks, the patient did not improve. On the contrast, the muscle involvement was really getting worse. The muscle enzymes were increasing. The patients developed problems getting up. He was dependent on a wheelchair, and he also developed problems swallowing, indicating even more severe muscle involvement. So we transferred the patient to our colleagues from the Department of Neurology, and they then initiated treatment with cyclophosphamide and also with intravenous immunoglobulins. And this finally and fortunately then was leading to an improvement of the patient's muscle symptoms, of his muscle enzymes, and also, as you can see here, of his skin symptoms. So the leg was going back to normal again. The patient was then treated with methotrexate, which was later switched to cyclosporine, and is in durable remission of his disease. I think there are two important aspects which are highlighted by this case report. And the first point is that in dermatomyositis, you need experts from different medical specialties in this case. This is really important because different organs are involved and you have to treat these patients and have to work together with specialists from other departments. This is important for a rapid diagnosis and for a good treatment. The second point, and second important point in this patients, is that in those cases where we have severe muscle involvement, like in our patient, we need a rapid therapy which has, of course, the ability to induce remission fast. And according to current guidelines, the first-line therapy are glucocorticoids, which have to be used in usually in high doses to induce remission, in addition with immunosuppressants like azathioprine, methotrexate, or mycophenolate mofetil. If this is not able to induce, this regime is not able to induce remission, you can use intravenous immunoglobulins. And since 2021, there's one intravenous immunoglobulin which is licensed for the treatment of dermatomyositis. In some patients, for instance, those patients with malignancy, this may also be an option as a first-line treatment, because in the case of malignancy, we tend not to use immunosuppressive drugs due to the cancer which is present. Still some refractory cases where other third-line therapies are needed, and there are some promising data regarding the use of B-cell depleting therapies, or especially in cases with severe lung involvement, Janus kinase inhibitors.